For many women in South Africa, the COVID-19 pandemic and the ensuing lockdown arrived like a tsunami, barreling down upon unsuspecting mothers, wives, and sisters. The Forgotten Woman, the South African story, is a collective of 15 contributions from some of South Africa's most successful women. As they share their journeys of pain and despair to success and self-love, the proceeds of the book sales will go towards financially empowering and supporting women who have found themselves in heightened, vulnerable positions as a result of COVID. This will happen through the Women of Stature Foundation, and we are joined now by two powerful women indeed, Lynn and Venentia. Welcome to The Loft, ladies.
Thank you for having us.
Now, Venentia, you are the Women of Stature Youth Ambassador Award winner 2020.
So much.
So speak to us, please, in depth about why the Women of Stature Foundation saw the need to help other women during this time.
I think the primary role of the particular award that I won, the Youth Ambassador category, prioritizes the role of fundraising and trying to take that initiative and put it in the hands of the youth, because the future does lie in our hands at the end of the day.
It is obvious why you both were chosen to be a part of this great initiative, but your personal journey is nothing short of heroic. For those who have not heard it, please may you share how your journey from pain and despair has led you to the road of bravery and inspiration.
I am a survivor of multiple rape, teenage pregnancy, divorce, single parenthood, a dire, unfair, patriarchal business society. But how I transformed my pain into power. Three words, really. Choice, focus, and perspective. Choice. We don't choose our trauma. We don't choose the crisis, but we do get to choose how we respond to it. We do get to choose how it affects us. And I chose very, very consciously and very early in my life that I might have been violated, but that my dreams were not going to be violated. Focus. I decided very consciously that I would not focus solely on my pain. I had the ability to dream through my pain while experiencing fear. So I was in pain, I worked through pain, and eventually, in recognizing the value of my dreams and the purpose that my dreams were going to fulfill in my life as a healer, as a counselor, eventually my dreams got to diminish the pain. Perspective, it was 45 minutes. The first rape was 45 minutes of brutalization, of torture. A year later, I realized that it could have been 45 people who raped me. It could have been 45 days and not 45 minutes. And so gratitude really promoted perspective. And it still does for much of my life. And that knowing that never mind what we go through, someone out there is going through a million times worse has really withheld me from victimhood.
Now, Venentia, moving over to you, in 2017, you then decided to launch your own Instagram page with the goal to transform the way women view themselves, especially when they browse through social media. And you are a content creator, and you have designed this to empower, educate, and inspire. So why was this important for you to transform women's views about themselves and talk about the journey of ending girl hate?
The whole campaign actually started after I met Leanne Dlamini, who is the founder of hashtag Ending Girl Hate. And one of the things I struggled with as a young person was having this dream and this interest or this passion to actually make a difference, but not feeling as though I had any resources at my disposal. And so being able to take social media, which is a resource that is available to many of us at any point in our lives, I think, and to use it to actually pivot that conversation, and rather than encouraging competition, which I think is at the center of conversation amongst young people, you know, we scroll through content and we constantly feel like someone is doing one up or one better than us. And the second part, being able to be a relatable inspiration for young people out there, and to drive the conversation of education. conversation and using our voice and whatever resources we have to bring about change.
Now, Lynn, moving on to your book now, Butterfly, My Soul Got Wings, What Life Has Taught Me. You mentioned that if we never share the lessons, we nullify the experience. Please do share your message that you want, or you're trying rather, to give across to your audiences.
The message that I'm absolutely trying to get across is that you are not the event. You are the response to the event. And so our human spirits has the capacity to transcend by virtue of our willingness to choose to do so, any trauma and any crisis. The other thing is that we look at situations and we say, you know, the situation and is holding me captive, or the person attached to the situation is holding me captive. But what I'm really trying to get through is that it is our thoughts and our feelings and our perspectives about life and about the situations that either hold us captive or set us free. Lastly, I don't think any human being's able to optimize their human potential and fulfill their dreams in a state of anger and unforgiveness. And as much as pain diminishes us in terms of our authentic identity and power, so does anger and unforgiveness. And what I'm trying to get across in the book is that in any given moment, never mind what goes down in our life, we have the capacity to assume a huger identity by virtue of the choices we make as to how it affects us and our destiny.
A very powerful message. Lastly, ladies, we have run out of time, unfortunately, but I just have to get a final nugget of hope, of love, and of faith to our South African audiences, especially the women out there that have to face so much difficulty and adversity, Venentia.
The one thing that definitely stands out, especially this Women's Month, is a lot of women are fighting back on the conversation around being strong women, because that has opened up so much room for abuse and disrespect, because this, you know, this woman is viewed as a rock and nothing can strike her, nothing can hurt her. But to actually change that narrative and to say, own the truth on your own terms. Be willing to tell your story on your own terms. Be willing to drain, from that story and to build from your core and to tell it on your own terms rather than to have it done to you, if I can call it that. So I think just that opportunity for us not to seek permission to own our truth how we want to, and to be vulnerable when we feel we need to be.
We don't choose the damage, but we do get to choose our healing. We so easily succumb to the fact that as women, we don't have power. And I actually want to close off with two lines from my latest poem saying that, in fact, we do have power and that our choices really is exactly that. And the two lines go like this. Queen, your choices are your riches, the lasting effects that can build or break your kingdom. The vastness of your mentality, of your consciousness, creates the experiences inside your royal territory. And that for me really is, queens, you are inherently powerful. You were born this way. Assume that power.
As we're wrapping up this interview, thank you so much, ladies, for this incredible wealth of knowledge and, of course, bringing us the book, The Forgotten Women. We appreciate it. Goodbye, Lynn and Venentia.
Thank you. Bye.
South Africa, please do head over to your local bookstores or online to find out how you can get yourself a copy. And do remember, the proceeds are going to a worthy cause. Use that hashtag AfterUnionExpress if the message from Lynn and Venentia resonates with you.